the that exam we are going to observe. First submitted exam knowledge question paper with explained the examples. And now we are on the question number 5. In the last question we saw about the question number 4. So question number 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th over. Question number 1st is there for 1 mark each. Here they are multiple choice question, that is the objective type of questions, and they are having the 1 marks for each, like that 8 questions are there. For the total first question is there for total 8 marks. Second question is also there, that is the main second question, in that there is the answer in one sentence, and in the, for that also for each question 1 mark is there, and total there the 8 questions are there for 8 marks. So, second question is also there for 8 marks. Next one is there, that is the main third question is there, the third question, and there are the, here it is a each question carries, or each question has the 2 marks. There are total 8 questions are there. So, totally 16 marks are there for the third question that we yesterday saw, or in the last question we saw it. Next one, question number 4 is there, that is for the each question carries the 3 marks. And like that there are 9 questions are going to ask. So there are the 9 questions for each question and there are the 3 marks. So totally there is for the question number 4, 27 marks are there. Now the next question is there, question number 5. And here each question has, or each question carries the 4 marks. 4 marks for the each question, and totally there are the 4 questions are going to ask. So here for that 16 marks are there for the question number 5. Here we are going to see now about the examples for the which question number 4. Here question number 5 is there for that. When 2 questions are there, we are going to solve the examples. So here example 1 is there, that is the extract roasting and maceration method of a zinc ore. As you know, the extraction of a metal for the low activity series, for the middle activity series and high activity series. And here explaining the earlier roasting and calcination method from the metal and non-metal lesson is that the purification of metal, or that is the extraction of metal from the oxide, from the sulfide. So how it is going to take place, and that is for the different activity series which are the having a low reactive, they are low activity series, middle activity series, high, means here they are the highly reactive, that are the high reactivity series, metals are having the high reactivity series. Activity series are there, in that here there is the extraction method is there. So all that extraction methods for the low, middle and high activity series, they are also very much important for your syllabus. So here explaining the roasting and calcination method, and this question is there for the middle activity series. Sometimes that question is going to ask, means explain that one directly asking for the middle activity, extraction of the metals of the middle activity series. Otherwise, going to ask like the roasting and calcination methods only. So here, roasting and calcination method, explain that one for the zinc ores, about that question is there, and this is the 4 mark question. So, first of all, what is the roasting? The sulfide ores, as you know, they leave the ores are there, we are metals, whenever extraction of metals are there, like the middle activity series are there, when extraction is going to take place, like the zinc ore extraction we want to do. So, it is a easier, that is a, first of all, it is necessary, it will convert into the oxides. Extraction of oxide is easier than the from the sulfides and the carbonates. So, first of all, it is a necessary to convert it into the oxides, and then that oxides again it is converting into the here on extraction of that metals are there going to take place. So middle activity series like a zinc is there, we are getting that one into the here in the form of the sulfides and also the here carbonates. So first of all, it is necessary to convert it into the oxides. So which are the methods, and that is nothing but the roasting and calcination method. For the sulfide and calcination method for the here carbonates. So what is the roasting method? The sulfide ores are converted into the oxides by heating strongly in the presence of excess air. Sulfide ores are there, they are converted into the oxides. So here at first we are getting that one into the first crust, that we are, it is necessary that convert into the between oxides by heating strongly. And how that one converting into the oxide? When that sulfide ores are there heating strongly in the presence of excess air. When excess air is there in the presence of excess air, when we are heating that one, then this process is known as the roasting method. So this is the roasting method for the sulfide when in the presence of excess air, heating strongly in the presence of excess air. And so here is the zinc sulfide is there. When the zinc sulfide ore is there, that one heating strongly in the presence of an excess air will be there. So if the oxygen is there, that is combined with the zinc and there is the formation of a zinc oxide. And so like the equation also explained the roasting and calcination methods of zinc ores. In that equations are there, every kind is very much necessary. So zinc sulfide plus SiO2, that is the in the form of a gas present in the air. So heating method is there and in the presence of air is there, there is the formation of a zinc oxide in the form of solid and also sulfur dioxide gas to form. So this is the roasting method. Next one method is there, that is the calcination method. So calcination method, the carbonate ores are changed into the oxide. The same method is there for the sulfide, how they treat them. Heating strongly the sulfide in the presence of an excess air, like that for the carbonate ores. Carbonates which are getting in the earth's crust, ores of that. When we are getting that metal ores, when we want to extracting for the middle activities, it is that it is in the form of a carbonate they are present. Here they are present in the form of a sulfide. So we want to separate the sulfide and carbonates. And so for that purpose, this roasting and calcination method is using. So the carbonate ores are there, they are changed into the oxide. Carbonate also basically converted into the oxide. These are sulfide in the form, these ores of the zinc getting in the form of sulfide. These ores of zinc getting in the form of carbonate. And so we want to convert nitrogen into the first of all in the oxide. So here is ZnO. So metal oxide formations are there, they are necessary. And so there is a roasting and calcination. When the sulfides or metal ores are getting in the form of sulfide, there is a roasting method. When the metal ores are getting in the form of a carbonate, then calcination method is used in the. So in the calcination, the carbonate ores are changed into the oxide. This carbonate ore of the zinc is converted into the oxide by heating strongly. When we are heating that one strongly in the limited air. See in the roasting method where it is heating strongly in the presence of excess air is there. Here we are using the limited air. And so here, and then that process is known as calcination. So ZnCO3 heating up strongly but in the presence of a limited air. So ZnO that is in the form of a zinc oxide, or we are getting in the form of a solid and carbon dioxide gas is. This is for the here calcination and roasting method and also both equations are there necessary. So this can be 2 marks for each roasting and calcination with equation when we are writing. So this is the example that is for the question number 1. For the answer the following will be here 7 to 8 sentences each. It has 4 marks for each question. So like this there are the 4 questions are there. The second question we are going to see for the 4 marks question. Draw a chemical diagram of the reaction of zinc cations with the sulfuric acid and also testing of a hydrogen gas. The diagram we have to draw. It carries here 3 marks. And also another question is there. Write the example for the neutralization reaction. So any question asking on landing, we can asking like this, that question is also for marks are there distributing. So in this, you should draw the diagram of here, reaction of a zinc cations with the sulfuric acid. So there are the paper test tube in that zinc cations and sulfuric acid here, they in the test tube, and as you know, here there will be the formation of bubbles. And that bubbles are passed from the soap solution. And there you are observing that in the soap solution there is the formation of bubbles. It will come up with the soap solution. In that soap solution, which gas is there? Because here changing the diamonds are reacting with sulfuric acid, it generates the hydrogen gas. That hydrogen gas was part from the delivery tube, and that hydrogen gas present now in the soap solution bubbles are there, so that the hydrogen gas is there and it will move outside. Hydrogen gas is a here, we know when it's a lower, so it will move up with the soap solution bubbles. And when you are bringing the one splinter here to that bubbles here, one splinter of that pipe here, then it is a burning of a hydrogen gas in the fog sound, because hydrogen gas is a very flammable gas. So because of that, there forms or it will burn with a fog sound. So this is about the diagrammatic representation for the here. Emerging granules with a sulfuric acid, drawing it label like that with a pencil, and sometimes asking for the labeling, label it at yourself. Sometimes some labels they are doing, that only you should label it. So draw neat label like that. And second question asking that write example for the neutralization reaction. So neutralization is not the acid reacts with the base. Formation of a neutralization reaction, and in this reaction salt and water is forming. So example, here it is very easy one, it is NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide base and hydrochloric acid, that is HCl. When reacts both the base and acid, there is a formation of a salt and water, NaCl plus H2O, this way water will form. And so this is the real equation or reaction of the example for the neutralization reaction. So this is the second question. In the second question, ask for the diagram, and also another one question asked for, that is the hydrogen neutralization reaction. This is the 1 mark question, and that is the 3 mark question total. If this question carries the 4 marks. So these are the 2 examples I gave here for the 4 marks question. Answer the correct questions, which carries the each question carries the 4 marks. There are really 4 questions are there for you to ask. So totally here total marks are there, that are the 16 marks are there waiting for the question number 5.
Dividing into the 3 1 1 marks, like otherwise 3 2 marks, otherwise 2 2 and 1 mark, like this they are dividing, but this question number 6 is there, it carries a 5 marks. So only one question in that identity is maybe dividing. So first question in the question number 6, that is the draw a neat label diagram or neat diagram of a brain, and label the parts. Which parts are there you are going to label, that the debris behavior. Sometimes going to ask the draw neat label diagram of the brain, but sometimes going to ask the draw diagram of the brain and also label the parts which they are giving here. So sometimes they are giving which parts are labeling, that parts only you should label it there. If they are not asking like that, only draw neat label diagram, means all labeling you should do it properly. And another question, that question number 6 asked B1, that is name the hormone secreted by the pituitary gland and that its function. So here 2 questions are there. So brain is there for the 3 marks and there is the here another question is there, pituitary gland, that which hormone is the secreting, and also the their function should write. So like this there is a mark distribution is there, and it which carries the 5 marks for question number 6. So draw on a neat level diagram of the brain. You should draw the brain, you practice the so much diagrams properly. So here is the diagram of the brain is there, you should practice it properly, and label the parts like cerebrum is there, or cerebellum is there, spinal cord is there, pons is there, medulla oblongata is there. So there are the different parts are there, or the pituitary gland is there, hypothalamus is there. So these are the, or also midbrain you have to show, otherwise core brain is there, that you should show. So like this the big parts. Now here they are only cerebrum and cerebellum and
and spinal cord.
These three levels are stressed, so I am not here. I labeled only that you only ask you also what they are asking, that you should label it properly. If they are not asked, any labeling will not give, we should label all the parts properly. Whatever means, like a pituitary gland, hypothalamus, forebrain, midbrain is there, pons is there, medulla oblongata is there, so I think pons and medulla oblongata is there. So that also you should label it properly. But here what I have question they asked, not be that much. Labeling, sir, you should label the three questions properly and draw the diagram what they asked. So label the parts of what they ask you here. Next question is, there are many hormones secreted by the pituitary gland and nitrates function. So as you know, in that hormones secretion is there by the near animals or human beings, about that we learned in that lesson. As here, but the like coordination, you know about that there are the different hormones are there, they are secreting the by the different glands. Like a adrenal gland is there, adrenaline hormone. When there is a emergency situation or scary situation is there, that time there is the emergency hormone is there secreting, and that is called as a adrenaline hormone. And it is a very much a user. This is called as the emergency hormone. When there is a scary or fear situations are there, when we are facing some problems, that time that hormone is there going to secrete. So. And also there is a different hormone, like insulin is secreting by the pancreas. So there are the and in males and females there is a testosterone, and the also estrogen is the in the females. Like this different hormones of the sex are there that are secreting by the reproductive organs of that male and female organs are there in that. Also there is the different hormone like a thyroid gland secretes a thyroxine hormone. It affects because iodine is very much necessary for the secreting of the thyroxine hormone. Otherwise it causes a goiter. That patients are also going to ask for otherwise insulin secreting by the pancreas, and there is a sugar level is there. It is not secreting sugar level, it is a blood sugar level is there. To maintain it, there is insulin is very much necessary. And so these are the some questions that they are going to ask. Are hormones, which hormones secreted by which glands, and write that hormone name and also about its function. Like the liver hormone is there secreted by the pituitary gland. There are many hormones secreted by pituitary glands, but if you for your study only like FSH is there, ACH is there, ACTH is there. So like this, the follicle stimulating hormone is there, FSH. So like this, there are the different hormones are there secreting by the pituitary gland. But for your study, there is the growth hormone is there only here, and that is hormone secreted by the pituitary gland. And growth hormone, what its function is, regulates that growth and the development of our body. If it is not secreting properly before the puberty, it leads to the dwarfism, and before the puberty, if it is secreting excess, it leads to the gigantism. So these are the deficiencies are there that one causing the deficiency there of the growth hormone. There is a regulates the because of the function is there, like it regulates the growth and development of the body, and so growth and development not causes properly. So these are the functions are there, and hormones, all the hormones which are secreting by our body, and which are the glands are there, that exocrine glands that name properly, and also about that hormones also you learn it properly, its functions are also very much. And what if any deficiency is there of that hormone, then what are the symptoms are there, or what our body is showing the diseases, about that also you should learn it properly. So this is the question number 6 is there, and it carries the hormones. And this is about the then distribution is there for the here, like 3 and 2 months, otherwise sometimes for 4 and 1 months also going to ask. So it depends on the question also, which question.